Our singular aim is to make you matric exam.
Okay, guys, the concluding section of calculus would be to look at how to apply. And calculus is just complete physics. And it can be used to do a lot of things in math. It's called modeling. Actually, what we're doing right now is called modeling. All right, optimization. That's, some people call it optimization. But basically, it's application. Before we start, when we talk about calculus, don't forget something here, that calculus is basically the study of gradient. That's one thing I want us to remember. Calculus is the study of gradient, how gradient behaves. And what we know is this: whether it's a parabola, whether it's a cubic function, we're looking at gradient. The gradient at the top, that's the gradient there. Of gradient at the top there. And gradient here. What do we know? It's equal to what? Zero. That's the whole idea of application of calculus. And what do we know at this point? This point is called the maximum point. What do we know at this point? It is called the minimum point. So it means, basically, when we talk about application, we're talking about maximum and what? Minimum. That's why we say optimization, optimum. All right? Maximum and minimum, optimization. And what we know here is simply our first derivative should be equal to what? Zero. And that's all. The rest is just finding, they are just finding their way into calculus. Top, when we say maximum, and please note the synonyms. Maximum, the farthest, the biggest, the lightest. All right? Minimum, the smallest, the lowest, the shortest. Those are words. What does that talk about? Extreme. What is the farthest you can go? That's the maximum you can go. All right? What's the lowest mark a person can get? That's the minimum. We are only saying the first derivative is equal to what? Zero. Now, some key things, concept and instructions on what to do, and we'll start calculating. Concepts and the instructions of what to do. When the examiner says the rate, guys, every time we say rate, it means we are dividing by time. So rate simply means division by what? Time. And what do you do there? You derive. You derive. So every time you see the word rate, the rate of change. Is that okay? So basically we're saying, let me say rate of change. Rate of change. When we say rate of change, it means we are measuring something against what? Time. Number two. So when you see rate, know that you're deriving. Is that okay? When they tell you something is changing, increasing or decreasing with time, again, may not be time, it may be another concept. Again, it's the same word. We derive again. Number three. Now, if I say the rate of change of a changing variable, mm-hmm. Now, if you notice, how many times did I use change? Twice. Something is changing. Then I'm looking for the rate at which that thing is changing. If it's changing, I'm deriving. If it's changing again, I'm deriving again. So this one means what? A double what? Derivative. Example, acceleration. Acceleration is a double derivative. Quickly going to look at one concept that I love so much when I do this. All right. Let's look at the concept of distance quickly. And as math learners, we all need to know this, whether you're doing physics or not. This basic one, we're all supposed to know this. Okay. Now, in grade 10, or from grade 8, we used to do this triangle thing. Do you remember? Where we say what? D, S, T. Okay. And what does S stand for? Speed. What does T stand for? Time. What about D? Distance. So what do we know? We know that speed is what? Distance over... We said something earlier on. Every time time is a denominator, rate, we derive. Does that make sense? This is a derivative already. So, given, let's look at this. Given that y equals to vi delta t plus half a, let me just use t. Vi t plus half a t squared, where y is the distance and time is, t is time. Those of us doing physics, we have an idea of what that formula is. Now, if I tell you what is the rate of change of distance, listen, this is distance, right? Now, what is the rate of change of distance? The fact that I'm seeing rate, what am I doing? Deriving. But with respect to what? Time. Because rate talks about time. So I'm going to have dy dt. What would it be? This is to the power 1, right? We do what we've been doing. 1 times vi. Vi. Then we subtract 1 from there. 0. Exactly what we've been doing. Differentiating with respect to time. Plus, what is 2 times half? 1. Okay. A. Can I subtract 1 from the time on top there? Oh, Vi plus A T. That is velocity. I don't know if we see that. That is, remember, the rate of change of distance, we're coming back here, distance over time is what? Speed. It means we are saying our speed equals to what? Vi plus A what? T. This is why when you throw an object up, vertical projectile motion. Now, what do we know at that point? What do we call that point? Stationary, or what we call in now maths, maximum. Now, what do we know at this point? Our first derivative must be equal to what? 0. Now, already we are applying now. At this point, what do we know? It is maximum. Our first derivative must be equal to what? 0. What's our first derivative? Dy dt. And what is that? Speed. So that means at the top here, at the maximum, dy dt, which is equal to what? Speed, is equal to what? 0. This is why in physics you say at the maximum height, the velocity is... Basically what they are saying is at the maximum height, the rate of change of distance, the first derivative, is 0. That's, we're done with that application of calculus. Now, so I'm already saying, check, that is my speed, right? Speed is VI plus what? 8. And speed, I can also say it's the same thing as velocity, right? It's just a vector quantity. Now, so it also means velocity equals to what? VI plus what? 80. Can we find the rate of change of velocity now? Rate of change of velocity. Remember, once I put the word rate, it means divided by what? Time. So what do I have? dv dt. Now, VI is a constant. If I derive, it's 0. What about AT? It's A to the power 1. 1 times A. Good. We have just done the definition. The rate of change of velocity is acceleration. That's physics definition now again. And that's your point of inflection. The point of maximum or minimum gradient. And that is all. The rest is algebra. I promise you. The rest. So what happens with calculus? It brings in algebra. It brings in tree. It just has love. It's very greedy. Calculus is greedy. It wants trig. It wants finance. It wants. Oh, you'll see finance. Calculate the maximum amount. It wants measurement. It wants everything. Let's run through a few questions, guys. And I'm hoping that I'll be able to make things a lot easier for us today as we go through. We have how many questions to look at? About 8 or so. So after 8 questions, we must find our feet somewhere and see the pattern of answers. And you can see we're just choosing those questions at random. Okay. I'm going to start. Look at this one. A particle moves, I hope we can all see. A particle moves according to the function h of t equals to minus 2t squared. So they've given us, read, please, always read. Where t is what? The time in seconds, and h is the height in meters above the ground. Are we okay? H is the height. T is the time. Guys, calculate the height of the particle after 5 seconds. Give me an answer. Please, that one is not even calculus. That one is what? I don't know. Calc. The loss is lost. Please, let's calculate. We know the height, the formula for the height. We are now looking for the height after what? 5 seconds. I don't think that should be difficult. What do we do there? We just substitute 5 and we're done. So take time to read the question. Can we get an answer there? 9.1. What's our answer? So we say h of 5 equals to minus 2, 5 squared plus 70 multiplied by 5. That's 350 there. And that's 25. 25 times 250. 350 minus 50 will give you what? 300. Done. Is it meters? Yes. 300 meters. Lovely. We're done, guys. Thank you. Thank you. How much time did it take the particle to hit the ground again? Lovely. Lovely piece. Wait. I want you to learn to interpret. If the object is now on the ground, watch. A particle moves according to the function. What is the time? Height above the ground. Now, if the particle is on the ground, what's the height? Done. We're looking for time. 0 equals to negative 2t squared plus 70t. We're done. That's what I'm saying. Just read and enjoy it. Object is now on the ground. Are you done? And I want to show you what your answers would be. We should have two answers here. Please be careful. Don't just divide. Can we factorize? Please don't divide. T is common. I want to show you. I want to explain something to you. That's what I'm saying. Don't divide. Minus 2. Or if you like, you can bring out minus 2T. It doesn't matter. All right. Okay. Can we take out minus 2T? What do we have? T minus 35. So it's either negative 2t equals to 0 or t minus 35 equals to 0. So t equals to 0 or t equals to what? It makes sense to have two answers. At t equals to 0, the object is on the ground. It goes up. And at 35 seconds again, the object is on the ground. Does that make sense? T equals to 0 and T equals to what? 35. So the object is on the... Look at... Don't think Mets people don't speak English. Watch this. How much time did it take the particle to strike the ground again? Which means it's in contact with the ground two times. Before it left and after it bounced. Does that make sense? What is the maximum... height that the particle reached? Okay, hold on. We're looking for the maximum height. Give me. Let's check something. What's the formula again? HT equals to. All right. Plus. All right, guys. I want you to watch this. Maximum height. I don't want you to think I'm not doing physics. So, look, it is a parabola. Do you notice that that equation is a parabolic function? I'm going to do so many things just on this one question now. It is a perfect parabola, guys. Object goes up, and then it goes down. T is zero. T is 35. What is your axis of symmetry? It passes through the turning point. That's halfway. What is 35 divided by 2? Good. That means this object took 17.5 seconds up and then it took 17.5 seconds down. So we know it traveled for 17.5 seconds. Can I then get the height at 17.5 plus 17.5? What's your answer? 612.5. Let's confirm. Do we agree? Guys, I need answers from home. I need answers from home. All right, only Kito's giving me an answer there. Hold on, guys. What do we know at this point? It's the maximum, right? What do we know? The first derivative should be equal to what? Zero. Because so the examiner is saying maximum, so I know that my first derivative equals to what? Zero. Okay. Can we derive this? I'm going to say H prime of what? T. What will it be? We all know how to derive. Negative 40 plus 70. Is that fine? Now, at the maximum height, that, please always write that and make it equal to what? Now, check this. Minus 40 plus what? 70 equals to what? Zero. Minus 40 equals to minus. Do you want to give me an answer for T? What's your answer? Lovely. So somebody who doesn't know physics, because here on the left-hand side, we use the knowledge of vertical projectile motion. But don't say, oh, I'm doing accounting, I'm doing business, I'm doing history, I don't know. No. At maximum height, the first derivative is equal to, so now we know the time it took. Can we now get the maximum height? What do? We substitute h of 17.5, which we have done already, for those of us that know that that's the maximum height. Because some people then tend to relax to say, ah, this one is for physics student. No, guys, the one on the left is for physics. The one on the right, check this. I wanted to see the beauty of this, that this is grade 11. My grade 11 learners that are here, they know. We did things like this. It's the maximum, and it's a parabola. What's the formula for your turning point? T equals to what? What's your turning point formula? T equals, now we're looking at T, right? Minus B over 2A. Minus, what's our B? 70 over 2. What's our A? Negative 2. Do you notice you have 70 over 4? And what's your T? 17.5. Guys, and you, no one will penalize you for whichever method you choose. But the only reason I am using minus b over 2a is because I see this as a quadratic function. Do we agree? Because it's t squared. I don't know. Did you get it? Shy. It's making sense. Good. All right, so do you see whatever we did, we still got 17.5? Okay, sweet. Let's check now. What was the initial velocity? Wait. Speed and distance. Speed and, we just did DST now, right? Once we mention speed, what do? We derive. Is that okay? We derive. So how do we then get the speed? All right, do we have our derivative already? So let's go do the speed now. Speed. Speed, we say it's what? The first derivative, right? So h prime of t. We got something earlier on. It was minus 4. Plus what? Minus 40 plus 70. All right. Guys, when we say initial, what does it mean? At the start. At the start, what's time at the start? Thank you. We're done. Initial. T. You are just starting. Does that make sense? You are just starting. So time is what? Zero. So all I need to do is to go and substitute my what? Zero there. What do I have? Minus 4, 0, plus what? 70. What's your answer? 70 meters per second. We're done. Yeah, we're done. So guys, it's about understanding the language and dealing with the concept. You don't run. You don't rush. You take your time here to read. Make sense? How's the first one? Getting there? It's not about physics. It's just math. All right. Okay. We've got this measurement. Lovely. I used to do this in grade 11. Things like this. The diagram below shows what? Triangle ABC drawn such that the vertices lie on a rectangle PBQS as shown. Now, PA is equal to SC. They've given us that, right? And PB equals to 12. That equals to what? 7. Calculate. Watch this. Calculate what? Smallest minimum. That's the language I'm looking for. Smallest what? possible. So it means I need to derive the area. So I must get the area first of the triangle and then derive it, solve it, and then look for the value. Is the concept making sense? Okay. So the question is, how do you get the area of this triangle? Now that is where the algebra comes in. What do we know? Area of a triangle. Okay. Basically, we're looking for the area of the shaded portion. It's either we look for the area of the whole thing and subtract the area that we of those things there. Alright? Or we say half base times height. But the question is, are we going to be able to get a height? Okay. But let's see something. It's 6 marks. If we decide to calculate the area of the whole box, that one's very simple. 12 times 7. I know you're going to use a calculator. But check. What is 2 times 7? 14. You take the 1 over. What is 1 times 7? 7 plus 1. 8. We are done. 84. Right? You find yourself. 84. Since that you guys like calculators a lot, that's the thing. Okay, now, but check. Do you think we can get the... How many triangles do we see here? There are 4. One is shaded, 3 are not shaded. So how do we get the area of the shaded one? Area of the total minus the area of the unshaded. We used to do that in grade 8 and 9. And you're thinking that was the end. Okay. It's never the end with math. Now, but my problem is, let's call this triangle 1, let's call this triangle 2, and let's call this triangle 3. Do you think we can find the area of triangle 1? Yes. Remember, the base and the height must be what? Perpendicular to each other. So, and I know that that's a rectangle. That's 90. Do you remember? That's also what? And this is also what? Don't you think we can get the area? Wait, before we... Okay, let's look at area of triangle 1. It's half base. Area is what? Half base times height. Half. What's the base? T. What's the height? 12. Doesn't matter which one, right? As long as they're perpendicular. What's your answer? 60. That is number one. What about area of triangle 2? The question is, do we know this small part? T minus which part? The whole length is 7. So this is 7 minus T. Because the whole length there is what? 7. Beautiful. So what do we have? Area will be what? Half 7 minus T. T. Does that make sense to you? Do you want us to simplify? What is half times 7? 7 over 2 minus T over 2. Everything multiplied by what? T. What would that be? 7 over 2t minus t squared over 2. Okay, we're there. What about the area of the third triangle? We know 7. What is going to be our CQ? 12 minus t, because we know that whole length has 12. It's a rectangle. So, this is what? 12 minus t. So the area of the third triangle will therefore be A3, which is what? Half. What's our base? 12 minus T. And what's the height? That is BQ, which is what? 7. And all we need to do is to simplify. If we multiply the half in first, half of 12 would be what? 6 minus T over 2 and multiplied by 7. What is 6 times 7? That will give us 42 minus 70 over 2. So we have the area of the 3 unshaded triangles. Now, what is going to be the area of the shaded? What do we need to do? Let's just duplicate this page. So we have all the information we need. Lovely. Remember, the area of the whole triangle is 12, rectangle rather, is 12 times 7. So we are going to subtract. Okay, let's take this away now. We are going to subtract. So
area of shaded triangle would be area of the rectangle, which is what? 12 times 7 minus, now we need to add all the three triangles together. Sum, we have 60, that's the first one. The second one is 7 over 2t minus t squared over 2 plus. The third one is 42 minus 7t over 2. I hope that makes sense. That's what we used to do when we were still in grade 8 and grade 9. Area of shaded portion. Now let's simplify quickly. 12 times 7 will give us 84. I think we can simplify this. All right. Negative times negative of the t squared would be positive t squared over 2. I want to see if we can start arranging. We've got some. All right. This is 7 over 2t. Look at this one here. Plus 7 over 2t minus 7 over 2t, that just falls away. So what do we have? We've got minus 60. Is that fine with you? And then we have minus 42. All right. So that's the area. So our area, therefore, is t squared over 2 minus 60. 84 minus 42 will be plus 42. So this is the area of the shaded portion. But what does the examiner want? The smallest possible. Now, since I am now saying smallest possible area, it will therefore be me deriving in terms of t. What are we going to get? The 2 would then come down. So it's going to be, let's do this so that everybody sees, over 2 minus what? 6. So basically we're saying t minus 6. That is the first derivative. Now, we know that for that to now be smallest, this has to be equal to 0. So t minus 6 equals to 0 and t equals to 6. But let's check. We are looking for the area. Always read through the question. We are looking for the area. Let's see, get a better one. All right, so maximum area, therefore, will be area would be, we substitute back, our t is now 6 for it to be minimum, minus 6 multiplied by 6 plus 42. All right, that was simply 36 divided by 2, that's 18 minus 36 plus 42. That will be 60 and that will be 24 centimeter squared. And that's how we get that. Quite simple and straightforward. So there's more algebra before the calculus. And by the way, let's see something here quickly. Because I see this as a quadratic. All right, because this is a quadratic, I could also use, see, once I identify that it's a parabolic function, I could then say t equals to minus b. Only when you see this as a parabolic function. Minus, our b is what? 6 over 2, and our a is half. Okay, and you would see there, oh, it's minus b, our b is negative, right? Lovely. So there's a negative in front there. 2 divided, 2 times half is 1, and that will give us what? 6. Our t is 6. Again, so minimum and maximum refers to the turning point, and that's why we derive. So if it is a cubic function or anything else, we just derive, saying we know that the turning point, we're talking about the turning point, minimum and maximum. But if it's a parabola, we can just derive. So a grade 11 learner can actually deal with this question. Awesome. All right, let's move on to the next one. Okay, let's check this one. A dairy company wishes to market its milk in rectangular carton containers. Look, read the story. It's modeling. Rectangular carton containers. Are you picturing a rectangle there? But it's a carton. So it's a 3D kind of image. All right. The volume. Okay. Now, what is the volume of any area, of any shape? It is the area of its base times the height. Never forget that. That volume of any shape is always the area of base area of base times what? Perpendicular height. So you check the base. Please remind me, I want to talk about cylinders. Closed cylinders, open cylinders, a glass. We did that in grade 11 when we're doing measurements, just to remind you. All right. The volume of the container must be exactly what? 1 liter. And they helped us by giving us a conversion, 1,000 cm cube. And the length of the base must be twice the breadth of the base. Ooh. Okay? It is... Let me see if I have a 3D here. No. I wish I had a 3D image. I was going to love it for the pirate, but I don't have. I wanted something extremely perfect. I know, but I wanted to just, you know, just have it. I wanted to have something. It's not. My OCD is not making. All right. Okay. So that's what we're looking at, something like that. Okay. Let me join this. Let me combine so that it doesn't separate. Combine. Good. I can now move it. Beautiful. All right. So that's what we have. Now, let's go back and interpret. So that's their container. Okay. The volume of the container must be 1 liter. The length of the base must be twice the breadth. Length must be 2 times. Does that make sense? That's how we interpret now. Twice. Okay. So, if I then call this, let's use L. That's the length, right? And this is what? The breadth. Is that fine? But the length is equal to what? 2B. Make sense? Good. Show that the height of the container can be written, they said where X is now what? The breadth. Lovely. So, X, what is the length going to be? You with me there? Okay. The examiner is referring to the volume. What is the formula for volume? The area of the base. Now, this base is a rectangular base. So what do we have? What is the area of a rectangle? Length times breadth times the height. What is our volume? 1,000. Do we know L? 2X. Do we know breadth? X. And height. Can we divide? We are looking for height, right? So what do we have? I want you to see your answer already. 2x squared h. Divide both sides by what? 2x squared. What do you have? What is 1,000 divided by 2? 500. And remember, your x squared is a denominator. We're done. Kuvadia, can you find AC and AB, then use half? On which one? On the first one. I'm just seeing your message. Is it this one, Kuvadia? Okay, let's come back to deal with this one, if it's this one that you're talking about. Let's come back and deal with it. All right, guys, do you see we have our height there? Okay. Determine the dimensions now of the container. If the surface area must be B. Good. What must be a minimum? Lovely. The surface area. Now, how do we get the surface area of? It's the soft. Don't craven cram the formula. If you have the formula right now, I don't know. But I'll tell you what I do. And I feel it's a lot safer than cramming. Because No, for me, I cannot cram. That's why I'm not a good actor. I can't cram. But check what I'm going to do.
why don't we check the surfaces that we have? This is length, right? 2x. We said this is what? X. And this is height, which is what? 500 over x squared. Now, how many surfaces do we have? We have 6 of them. The front and the back would be the same. The top and the bottom would be the same. The right and the left would be the same. Is that fine? Okay. So if we let's talk about the base. Remember we're talking about total surface what? Area of the base. 2x times, because they are all rectangles. But there are two of them. I don't know if this makes sense. Multiplied by x. Does that make sense to you? Because the area of this is what? 2x squared. But it's top and bottom. It's a closed curtain. So what's our answer? 4x squared. Top and bottom. In fact, let's do it at the same time. I don't want to... You guys are smart, so you can see what I'm doing. So total surface area, top and bottom would be what? 4x squared plus... Let's look at the side. It is x times 500 over x squared multiplied by 2. Do you understand why we're multiplying by 2? The left and the right. So what are we saying? 500 over x squared multiplied by x multiplied by 2. That one goes. What do we have? 1,000 over x. Plus, what side is remaining? The front and the back. Now, it is 2x and what? 500 over x. Does that make sense? Make sense? All right. So what's the area? 2x times 500 over, multiplied by what? 2 again. Front and back. Tap, tap. What do we have? 2 times 500 times 2. At least you're not using the calculator this time. 2,000 over x. Guys, that's my total surface area of all the surfaces. But what are we looking for? Let's go back quickly. Determine the dimensions. We need to look for length. We need to look for x such that that total surface area is a minimum. Oh, so since the examiner wants what? Oh, by the way, do you notice these are like terms? So can we simplify to say what? 4x squared. Guys, they are the same. Now that you cannot press X on the calculator, what do? Since the denominators are the same, we just add the top, right? Hey. That's why you must know the beauty of math. Now, minimum surface area, what do? We derive. Is that okay? So let's say surface area, let's represent surface area as area, it's fine. Can we derive, everybody? What do we have? Wait. We need to, before we derive here, that x must leave that place and go to the top. We did this when we're talking about the rules of what? Of deriving. All right. So, area would be equal to what? 4x squared plus 3,000 x to the power of negative 1. So, can we derive now? 8x minus 3,000. X to the power of negative 2. But now, this thing here must all be equal to what? 0. So let's do this. 8x squared minus, I would say, bring it back. Now, 8x. To solve, bring it back. And that should be equal to what? 0. Multiply everything by x squared. What are you going to get? 8x cubed minus 3,000 equals, because you are multiplying everything across. So what do we have? 8x cubed equals to what? 3,000. What is x cubed? 3,000 divided by what? 8. What would that be? Oh, Nana. Really? Okay, what's your answer? Are you sure? Did you find the cube root already? Now you are. That's why. Yeah, cube root. So x is what? 7, comma. Please don't lose sight of the question. We only got x. What are we looking for? The dimensions. So you must find the length, the breadth, and the height. That's what dimension is. You must get, guys, this, you got x, which is just what? The base. What about the length? L equals to 2x. So you multiply that by 2. Don't forget, read the question. Dimensions, 14.42. Now, what about the height? 500 over x squared. Get that answer. At least it's making sense gradually, guys. What's the answer? 9.62. Lovely. So that's the pattern. Do you see where math is important? So a company that wants to do cartons, they don't just do cartons. They call a mathematician. We don't want to waste money. So what is the minimum size of our cartons? That's where we are important, guys. Don't think we just shout X and Y at schools. No. They call us to model. What should be the measurement if you don't want to waste? How do we break even? What should be the maximum? It's called modeling. We want to go to war. They call it mathematician. We model who's going to win the battle. Wow. You think we are just shouting X and Y? We don't just shout X and Y. What's our unit? Centimeters. Centimeters. Yo, 4 marks. Well, it's injustice. Anyway, you are saying injustice because you know what to do. Now, before I did it, you were saying it's okay. Yeah. You would skip it. Yeah. But now, imagine if it's not 10 marks. Okay. You come back. All right, let's look at this one. The diagram below represents the graph of y equals to x squared. Please, you still have a full day to watch this again. All right? The graph below represents the diagram represents the graph of y equals to x squared and rectangle PQRS. Okay. I did this question, something like this, something similar. P is a common point on both graphs. What? Or both the graph and the rectangle. I was saying how many graphs? All right, P is a common point. Okay. The graph of X equals to 6 and Y equals to 0 represent two adjacent infinite lines of rectangle. Okay. The coordinate of R, 6 and 0, and the coordinate of X, 6. I did something similar. In fact, in this case, you're even lucky they gave you 6 minus X. In that other one, the same question. In that other one, they didn't even give us 6 minus x. But we know that this will be x, and this in between will be what? 6 minus x. So they've changed the question a little bit here. It's different. Yeah, you see that it's different. So don't let me bring that in. Okay. All right. Guys, I want us to see this quickly. Let's see this thing. What is r? 6. What is q? 6 minus x. Is that fine? All right. Write down the coordinate of P in terms of x. What do we know as coordinate of P normally? Coordinate should have x and y value, right? Okay, so P should be what? X and y. No, it's... Okay, now, but what is the value of x at that point? 6 minus x. Make sense, everybody? Okay, what about y? Hold on, don't forget, y is equal to what? X squared. So what is the value of x? 6 minus x.
But I don't know why they gave it one mark. But is that making sense, though? That the value of at x, at p there, our x is what? 6 minus x. But we know our y as x squared, and we know our x now, right? So can we simplify? What is the coordinate of p therefore going to be? 6 minus x point. What do we have? 36 minus 12x plus x squared. That's our coordinate. Determine the maximum area. Again, look at the word. Maximum. What are we deriving? Area. Now, what is the area of PQRS? I guess they know that learners may struggle with this. That's why it's not always a lot of marks, though. But let's get it. Guys, check this. If this is 6 minus x, and this is 6, what is the length here? It is 6 minus 6 minus x, and that is equal to x. Is that make sure? What about the vertical? What about the vertical? Remember that the vertical is now y. But what is y? X squared. So, does that make sense? By the way, what's the coordinate of P? I think we should rather use that one. This is P. It's the Y value. Is that okay? It is the Y value there. So what should we be having? Okay, X squared minus 12X plus 36. Because it's the Y value there. So what's the area? Area, therefore, is what? Length times breadth. X into bracket, x squared minus 12x plus what? 36, which is equal to what? X cubed minus 12x squared plus 36. Now, how do you find the maximum we derive? What are we going to get? 3x squared minus 24x. There's 36x here because we multiplied everything in. Plus what? 36. Can we derive? Can we now, since it's maximum, we equate that to what? 0. It's going to give us a trinomial, right? So what do we have? 3x squared minus 24x plus 36 equals to 0. Can I divide by 3 all through? X squared. Don't waste your calculator, please. I've already divided. Can we factorize? It's 6 and 2. Come on. X minus 6. X minus 2. So X equals to 6 or X equals to 2. What are we looking for? The maximum what? Area. So we are saying the area will be maximum either when X equals to 6 or 2. But hold on. Do you know what we've just said? One of them would be a maximum. One of them would be a minimum. So what do we need to do? We throw both of them in to see which one is bigger. But I can tell you which one will be big. Look at that area. It's a cubic function. X cubed minus 12x plus 36. My A is greater than 0. So it should be what? A smiley face? Is that okay? But where do we start from? We start from a sad face. All right. And end at what? And already I have my turning point. Watch this. This question is very tricky. Those values are my turning points, remember? Yeah. The first value is 2. The second value is 6. What do you notice about 6? It's the minimum. And 2 is the? I promise you, if we throw two, let's throw two back into this equation and also throw six. Our area formula. Okay. So area of six. Let's check. And area at two. I can do two, two. That is 8 plus 72. That's 80. 80 minus 2 times 2, 4, 48. 8, you should get 36 when you have 2. Is it 32? Okay. And when you have 6?
0.
How can the area be 0? So an example will say, a letter will say 6 because 6 looks bigger. Yeah. But the correct answer is what? So, the maximum area would be when X is equal to what? 2. So, this is the maximum area, unit squared. Guys, I don't know if it's taking shape gradually as we're moving on. It's taking shape. You know, as we're going on, that, okay, this is what you do when you see this. This is what you see when you do this. And this is the only thing I enjoy in calculus. But guys, I hope it's look. If you notice, I take my time to read and interpret what's going on. Is that okay? And then as I'm reading, I'm taking note of those words, maximum area. I know I have to derive the area. Sometimes they say which one is the maximum X. Then you don't have to substitute back. So read the question carefully. All right. One more. Okay, let's try. Okay, we've got this one. My dear learners, I know that you may have a challenge. Let's see. No, you've got a minimum amount. Okay, let's see. Look, you need your 3D. You need to be in class when you're doing this. Don't be absent-minded. A rectangular milk carton has a square base which holds 1 liter of milk. It has a specially designed fold-in top. The area of the cardboard used for the top is 3 times the area of the base. Okay, it makes sense. Because it's 3 portions. Area of the base. Show that the total surface area of the carton is given by that. All right, let's see. Total surface area of the carton. All right. Let's see something. By the way, we're going to close this curtain. Right? It's not going to look like an aeroplane when we finish. Okay. I'm thinking the sides must be folded. All right? So that at the top is just one surface, you see. Does that make sense? Okay, but let's see something. Let's calculate how many surfaces do we have. Oh, by the way, volume is 1, right? Don't forget. Volume is 1. Why am I telling you not to forget volume is 1? Do you notice that my formula has no H? Right? Formula has no H. It means you must get rid of that H. So, by saying, check, this is where I'll start from. What is my volume? Length times breadth times height. What is the length? X times h, and this is what? 1. Make sense? All right. So what do we have? 1 equals to what? X squared h. What is h? 1 over x squared. So at anywhere I get to where I see h, I substitute 1 over, so that all my variables are now what? X squared. In terms of x, rather. Okay. Let's start with the, where do we start from? Let's start from the side, from the front and the back. So TSA, can we say HX? Talk to me. We're looking at this. Let's look at this. HX. Guys, we must get this by crook or by hook. Force by fire. All right. H multiplied by what?
X.
What would that give us?
HX.
But there are two of them. Okay, 2HX. So we're good. Everybody? 2HX. But what is H? 1 over X squared. So 2, 1 over X squared multiplied by X. Let's show them that we have that. 2, 1 over X squared multiplied by X plus, okay? Can we deal with the side? Can we deal with the side? By the way, this and this will be the same. Because it's HX. So can I just change that to 4?
Make sense?
Okay. Because it's 4. All right. This thing doesn't want to erase. So we said 4, 1 over what? X squared multiplied by X, right? Plus, what about the base?
Length times breadth, X squared.
All right, times 2. Remember it's top and bottom there. 2X squared. However, I see something. Wait. This examiner is using 1,000. They've converted the liters into cm cube. Which is 1,000. So, can we just... Because that's what I just saw now. So, this becomes what? 1,000. Is that fine with you? 1,000. All right. So, this becomes what? 1,000. Do you notice your 4,000 over X is already there? Do you notice? Okay. Now, the bottom and the top. What did we say? X squared. Mind you, they told you, how many surfaces do you have at the top? There are 3 of them. It will be 4 with the bottom. I don't know if it makes sense. Because they told you that the top is 3 times the area of the base. So if the base is X squared, it means the top is what? 3x squared. But in total, 4x squared. Can we simplify? This would go, right? What do we have? 4,000 over x plus? It's a scam. But does it make sense, guys? By analyzing the question just carefully. All right. Determine the dimensions, which must get length, breadth, and height, so that what? The minimum amount of cardboard is used, which means the area must be derived. Can we derive that? Again, it's similar to what we did. Can this thing go up? So what do you have? 4,000 x to the power negative 1 plus 4 x squared. Now, can we derive a prime of x would be what? Negative 4,000. Can I just do that?
Are you with me there?
I've already minus 1 and dropped it immediately. Are you okay? You understand what I've done? Okay, if you derive, you're going to subtract 1 there, right?
Which is x to the power negative 2. Then I dropped it immediately.
All right. Plus what? 8x. Now, that whole thing should be equal to what? 0. I'm sure it's similar to that one. I think the only difference was 3 and 4. That one was 3,000. This is 4,000. So we're done. 6 marks again in the bag. I'm sure we can finish this, guys. So we can finish this one.
Yes.
You'd finish this on your own, right? Remember, then we say this whole thing here must be equal to what? 0 multiplied by x squared. Just similar. The only thing different is the 4 and the 3. All right. Right now, I can even tell you what the answer is. It's 4,000 divided by 8.
and the cubit of that. Yeah. And you can even do the 4,000 divided by here without a calculator. Let's just do it. I should stop it. So I know that X is going to be what? 4,000. Let me show you some few things divided by, and it's going to be X cubed, right? Remember? Look. Do you want to see the math? It's 4 times 1,000 divided by 8. You don't even need a calculator. 4 here, 1, 4 here, 2, 2 there, you have 500. That's the cube root of 500. And you'll be done. Anyway, you'd complete that, right? You find the length, breadth, and height. Let's check if there's something else. Let's look at this one quickly. Looks a bit different. Refer to the figure showing the parabola given f of x, is that right? What's wrong? Okay? F of x is that. That one you'll complete. Okay. Now, they give you a domain. Zero, x is between 0 and what? 4. D is a point, and DB is parallel, so it's a straight line. Okay. Write down, it's similar to that curve one that we did. Write down the coordinate of B in terms of x. They told us the x value is x already there. What is the y value? It is 4 minus x squared over 4. We're done. Because that's y. It's x and y. And they give me my y. Show that the area of OBD, which is a triangle. How do we get the area of a triangle? All right. Area is half base times perpendicular what? Height. Area is half base times perpendicular height. What is our base? X. Right? Now, what is the height? The height is DB, which is our Y value. What's our Y value? 4 minus X squared over 4. Can we multiply everything in? What is 4 divided by 2? So we're going to have 2 on top there, which is what? 2X minus, what is X times X squared? X cubed. 2 times 4 at the bottom? 8. We're done. Determine how far D should be the maximum distance. Okay, Kuvadia, I'll go back. Determine how far D should be, which is talking about what? We're looking for the value of X now. Is that okay? How far D could be? To give the maximum area. Can we derive this? Maximum area. What are we going to have? A prime of X. Are you deriving with me? What do you have? 2 minus 3x squared over 8. But that must then be equal to what? 0. So what do we have? 2 minus 3x squared over 8 equals 2. Multiply everything by 8. What do you have? 16 minus 3x squared equals to what? 0. 16 equals to what? 3x squared. Divide both sides by what? By 3. X squared equals to what? 16 over 3. What is x? Plus or minus square root of? The only reason I am not going to consider the negative is I've been given a restriction that x is positive between 0 and 4. But just take note. All right. What's your answer? Come, 4/3. Which will give you 4/3/6, 2/3. That will give you 2/3/3. 4/3/3. Okay, but give me it decimal. Guys, I hope when you see graphs like this, it's making sense of what to now do. Because the Y value is the function that they've given you. Okay? Thank you, Hamza. The Y value is the function that they've given you. Kuvadia, wait. Let's do this cylinder first, Kuvadia. I'll get back to that one. Running against time again. But I'll get back to that. Or rather, just send this PDF to you. Okay. Sam has a 16 meter steel cable to wrap around a cylindrical tank to strengthen the tank as you. Oh, there's one question I saw again. Okay, guys. Fine. There's one question I saw again that we need to do. To strengthen the tank as shown in the shaded part of the sketch. Okay, so there we go. Show that the height can be written as H equals to 8 minus 2R. Let's see again. Sam has a 16-meter steel cable. So, okay, so the total is 16. Okay, he wants to wrap it around. What are we showing that? Looking for the height. Okay, wait. If we say 16 meters, he wants to wrap around. That's the perimeter. Which means the four sides must give me what? 16. Does that make sense? So, can we say that 16, okay, no, let's say 2R plus 2R plus H plus H equals to 16. Do you agree with what? I don't know if you see what I mean. The whole length is 16, so it's a perimeter. So what do we have? 4R plus 2H equals to what? 16. We're looking for H, right? So 2H is what? 16 minus 4R. Can we divide everything by 2? 8 minus 2R. Sweet. We're done. Write down the volume of the tank. Good. This is a cylinder. Check. We are wrapping around a cylindrical what? Tank. Guys, I told you how to find the volume. Now, it's a tank. Everything is closed. Is that okay? Now, what is the volume of a tank? It is the area of the base times height. And the base is a circle. What's the area of a circle? Pi r squared. So what do we have? Pi r squared what? H. But they said in terms of r, we go and substitute our h. So what do you have? Pi r squared 8 minus 2r. What do we have? 8 pi r squared minus 2 pi r cubed. Does that make sense to you? That's my volume. What must the radius and the height of the tank be? Dimensions. So that the volume would be a maximum. What do? We derive. What are we deriving? Volume. Now, please, when you want to derive, make sure there's only one variable. Is that okay? So, can we find V in terms of what? R. What would your answer be? 16 pi R minus 8. Why am I saying 8? 6. My calculator is malfunctioning now. 6 pi R squared. But for it to be a maximum, that whole thing must be equal to what? Please, just write that thing there for the examiner. V that R should be equal to what? 0. So what do we have? 16 pi R minus 6 pi R squared equals to what? 0. What's common? R. Let's just leave the pi. We are hungry. 16 pi minus what? 6 pi R equals to what? 0. It's either R equals to 0, which would not make sense. The radius cannot be 0. All right? The dimension cannot be 0, rather. Okay, or what? 16 pi minus 6 pi R equals to what? 0. What would that lead us to? That would lead us to what? Okay, I could just do this. Yeah, you can solve. I did the final answer. 16 pi, right? 16 pi equals to what? 6 pi r. So what is r? R equals to 16 pi over 6. Because we're dividing both sides by 6 pi. The pi would cancel each other. They'll eat each other. What is 16 over 6? That is 8 over 3. And that is 2,67. Because it's 2,666666. But remember, we're looking for the radius and the height. You must come back and get the height. So what is our height? 2,8 minus 2,67. What's your answer? Meters. These are all in meters. Guys, I hope it's making sense. Kuvadi, I'm going to go back to your triangle question now. Thank you. Let me see. What do we have? All right. This one is similar. This one is cost. Let's leave this for Thursday. And this one. Okay. Let's leave this for Thursday. And then we play around with this one. And then we do it. Whatever question. Guys, whatever question you have, please send it in. So we can have it all together. But I'll do that part. Okay. Kuvadia, here is your question. You want this? You want that? Yes. Can you find AC and AB? AC and A. Yeah, we can. We can use Pythagoras. But now, my question would be, what will be the height? Let's try something. Okay, let's try. Let's just analyze. I would leave you to do it, but let's analyze. Just want to move it to a different page. Okay, so we can get this one. He's saying, wouldn't that be easier? Let's see. Let's engage. All right, we can get this side by using the theorem of what? Pythagoras, right? Basically, 12 squared minus t squared. All right, so this side is what? 144 minus t squared. What about this side? It would be 7 minus t all squared minus t squared. Okay. Now, so you said we should find AB and AC, which we already have. Now, where is the height of this triangle? Don't tell me you are thinking of this as the... Okay, where's your height? Let me ask you first. Kuvadia, what would be your height? The height must be from the vertex to the base, and it must be perpendicular. So we need to do some construction here. Let's see. If I use this as my vertex, it means check what my base would be. I want us to see. Let me use a highlighter. It's good to engage. I love the engagement. That's the base. So my height has to go down. Okay, if that's my base, and I do that height, 90 degrees. My problem will be to get this height. I don't know if you see what I'm trying to run away from. If I do this as my base, I would need to come here and get that perpendicular height, or even there. How do we get that height? Do you see the challenge of the height there? Yeah. Okay. So probably you were thinking one of these would be the height. So I think that would be the safest. Our way would be the safest way because of that height. See, if we had a way of getting the height, it would be a lot easier. But the height is a problem. Anyway, guys. Look, I'm glad we've concluded calculus. We just need to do more practice. Is that okay? Go through the five lessons. The five lessons are awesome. Listen, that lesson four was a blast. Looking at the relationship, it was a blast. Like, boom, like from nowhere. It was an atomic bomb. All right. And then lesson five, look at how we broke down optimization. So it's a matter of reading the question, finding an expression, and working through. Maximum, minimum, you derive. Make it, but watch what you are deriving. Is that okay? All right. I'll send you this slide, guys. Yes, you still have some days before we write. Okay, so we take these questions and you know, we handle them. We will handle them this time around. It's no longer malhandling us. We malhandle the questions, all right? Because of our time, we would stop here. Application number five, lesson number five. Any question, guys?
Do you find mental science difficult or challenging, or you want to upgrade your matric? Crazy Physics is your answer. The home of quality and inspired teaching of maths and science. We offer the best service in teaching in simplifying concepts with fun and easy-to-remember dynamics. No one does it better. Many have had their dreams set in motion under our tutelage. We want to be part of your success story. We offer both active and virtual tuition and homeschooling from grade 10 to 12. Are you working but need to upgrade your matric? Trust me, we got you covered. Holding your hands till you make it for your matric upgrade, wherever you are in South Africa. Our cloud and remote resources are adequately prepared to take you through every concept in detail. Simplified explanations, simulations to make you enjoy science and have fun with it. Textbook, workbooks, plug and play on the go class would also assist you as part of our resources. Why don't you just subscribe to our YouTube channel? Don't forget to hit the like button. Crazy Physics or Crazy Edu TV. Register now.